and welcome to Daily Current Affairs by Neo IAS. Today is 23rd July 2019 and the topic we are going to discuss is Right to Information Bill 2019, Section 376E, Bhabha Kavach, Bharat Mala Project and Map Aided Program and the previous year question version series. So the first three topics are a comprehensive topic, very small topics. We just have to go through it. Bharat Mala Pariyojana we'll see in detail. Okay. So, coming to the first topic, that's Right to Information Bill 2019. So, this is in news because the government, they had introduced this Right to Information Bill in Lok Sabha. So, the bill, it is proposed to amend Section 13 and Section 16 of Right to Information Act of 2005. So, currently it is Right to Information Act of 2005 and this particular bill is trying to amend two sections, that is 13 section and section 16 of the existing RTI Act. So, we have to know what section 13 deals with because right now RTI Act bill of 2019 has not come yet. So, we have to know what is section 13 and 16 of the existing Act. Okay, so the section 13, it deals with the term of Central Chief Information Commissioner and also the Information Commissioner. So, this particular term is set as 5 years or until he or she becomes an age of 65 years. Okay, whichever is earlier. So, this is what is mentioned in Section 13. And the new bill, it seeks to amend the appointment for such term, it will be prescribed by central government. Okay, so central government will propose or prescribe till what time a chief information commissioner should continue in his office. Okay, again in section 13, it also states about the salaries, allowances and other terms of services of the chief information commissioner and other commissioners. So, all those information again is going to be amended and the proposed amendment, it will be like the allowances and salaries will be decided by central government. Okay, and in case of state government, okay, state level information is contained in Section 16 of the RTI Act of 2005. So, in Section 16, it is stated that the state level Chief Information Commissioner and the Information Commissioner, they will stay for 5 years or till they achieve 65 years of age, whichever is earlier. So, this is again amended and this going to be amended and central government will decide the case of state Chief Information Commissioner and Information Commissioners as well. And while the original Act, it prescribed the salaries, allowances and other terms of the service of the State Chief Information Commissioner as same as that of Election Commissioner and also the salaries of the Information Commissioner, State Information Commissioner, it is equal to the Chief Secretary to State Government. This is the original norm, but the amendment it proposes that these shall be also decided by Central Government. This is like a new amendment is for getting a complete control over the election, Information Commission to the Central Government. Okay. The next topic is Section 376E. So, 376E is important, 376 is important, 376A, D, E, everything is important. Okay. So, this is in news because the Bombay High Court, they have said that Section 376E of Indian Penal Code, it is valid. It is constitutionally valid. Okay, so I'll tell you what 376E is. It is actually a provision to, punish a repeated rape offender. Okay, so a person who repeatedly rape people will be imprisoned for rest of his life. For example, if a person is committing a rape and he is getting a sentence of, say, 12 years or 7 years and he is going to jail. Coming back from jail, he is again trying to rape someone else, means he have to get again this particular extension of life sentence or sentence to death. Okay, so this is like a repeat rape offender who is being punished under 376E. Okay, this is a stringent provision. It is added by criminal law of 2013, and it was introduced after March 2012 gang rape case of Delhi. Okay, so in this, the definition of rape is widened to include also the oral and digital penetration, and the section 376E, it was added to award death penalty to a convict who is a repeat offender. Okay, so he might be already punished under 376, 376A, 376D, but again he will be convicted with 376E as well because he is a rape repeat offender. Okay, so section 376A, it is basically dealing with causing death of the victim, and 376D, it is to charge the convict with gang rape. So remember this, 376D is gang rape, 376A is causing death of the victim, 376E is repeated rape offender. Okay, so it is to repeated rape offender or the gang rape, they'll get from a sentence of 20 years to life sentence. So according to this criminal law of 2013, whoever has been previously convicted of an offense that is punishable under 367 or 367A or 367D, and he is subsequently convicted of an offense that is punishable under any of this above section, then he shall be punished with imprisonment of for life. Okay, which means that he shall be imprisoned for the remainder of his personal natural life or with death. Either he will be sentenced with death or he have to entirely live in jail for his rest of his life. Okay, next is Baba Kavach. Baba Kavach, this is in news because Baba Kavach, I'll tell you what Baba Kavach is, then I'll tell you why is it in news. Okay, Baba Kavach is basically a bulletproof jacket. It is the lightest bulletproof jacket that India have. Okay, so what they do is, it can even block the bullets of AK-47 or INSAS. Okay, so this particular Baba Kavach is being given to paramilitary forces. That is why this is in news. And it is jointly developed by Ordnance Factories Board and Midhani. Midhani is a manufacturer for metals and metal alloys. Okay, so they combinedly produce this Baba Kavach. So it can withstand the bullets from AK-47 as well as I have already told you INSAS rifle. Okay, so this is like very light, and it is half the weight of it is only half kg. That is but the existing bulletproof jacket, it is very very heavy. Okay, so the Kavach is a half kilogram less than the weight of the bulletproof jacket we already have with the paramilitary forces right now. Okay, and this has been prescribed by Home Ministry, and it will have four hard armor plates. Okay, it will protect from the front side, then the back and either side. So four plates will be there, and this is being built from the layers of polyethylene, and it is being fused at very high temperature, and it will be forming a thick armor plate by fusing this polyethylene. And this has been sprayed with carbon nanomaterial also. So carbon nanomaterial is provided by BARC. Okay, that is Baba Atomic Research Center. And the material used in the jacket, it is hard boron carbide ceramics. Okay, so it is like a complete package. Next is Bharat Mala Pariyojana. So Bharat Mala Pariyojana, you know what Bharat Mala project is. It is basically road development initiative. It comes under Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. This is in news now because LIC, they are going to fund this Bharat Mala Pariyojana. That is why this is in news. So this is basically an umbrella program. So what they do is, they take all the unfinished projects of National Highway Development Project. So National Highway Development Project, NHDP, was already in action. It started in 1998, and majority of its projects are like left unfinished. So this Bharat Mala Pariyojana, they'll take over all the unfinished projects of NHDP along with some new initiative. Okay, that is to provide better connectivity. All this are subsumed under Bharat Mala Pariyojana now. This has been launched in 2017. And what they do is, the project, it will have a coverage of 83,000 kilometers of road, and the investment is calculated to be 6.9 lakh crores, and this will finish by 2022. That is what we expect. Okay, and it will also include economic corridors, then inter corridors will be there, feeder routes will be there, then we'll have a national corridor efficiency program. That is the main thing. National corridor efficiency program. That means whatever we already have, it will be given, you know, more emphasis and given more efficiency. And also, it will also cover international connectivity roads, then border roads, okay, express highways, everything which has been dealing by NHDP will also come under Bharat Mala Pariyojana. Okay, and this will give the country around 50 national corridors, 50 national corridors, and we right now have only 6. Okay, so by finishing this project, we'll be having 50 national corridors. And also, the freight is now at 40% at present, and it will be increased to 70 to 80%. Okay, that will move along the road. And also, 3,300 kilometers of the border roads of strategic importance along our international boundaries will be made, and there will also be international connectivity, that's a road connecting for trade from India to the neighboring countries, that will also be done. So, international boundary road will be there, border roads will be there for the strategic importance, everything will be coming under Bharat Mala Pariyojana. Okay, so the main objective is to, you know, optimize the efficiency of road traffic movement. Okay, they'll bridge the critical gap, infrastructure gap that is still occurring in the country, and also they'll give improve the efficiency of national corridor, like the golden quadrilateral or the north south corridor, east west corridor. Okay, these will be, and there are many choke points in India. So, it is very congested also. So, they'll take over the decongesting of these choke points. They'll expand the road. They'll bring more lane. If it is a two-lane road, they'll make it 6-lane. And then there will be construction of ring roads. Bypasses will be there. Then elevated corridor will be there. Many provisions will be given in order to decongest the choke points. Okay. And also, there will be special attention towards the connectivity for backward or tribal areas or areas of low economic activities, or there are regions like religious places, tourist places where there is no big infrastructure, road infrastructure is there. They'll try to connect all these places, then border area, then coastal areas, trade routes, everything will be taken care of. Then they'll also try to help connect 550 districts in the country through national highway linkage. Okay, and currently actually only 300 districts have been connected to the national linkage, so they are making it 550. Okay, then okay, one more thing is there, Bharat Mala, it will have a positive impact on logistic performance index that has been released by World Bank. Okay, so the newer road, they are expected to increase the speed of vehicles, and it will decrease the supply chain cost. Okay, so these are the major objectives of Bharat Mala project, and the funding, obviously the funding, it will be 70% of the funding will be coming from the government only, and the rest of the fund, they are coming from various sources. Several routes are there, like debt funds will be coming, budgetary allocation. Every year we'll be allocating a certain amount of money for Bharat Mala. Then private investments will be there. Toll operated transfer model, that will be like if a road is completed, we'll have the provision for collecting tolls. So that is a way to collect more money. And the 1/3 of the investment, it will be coming from fuel cess. Okay, fuel cess has been increased in this year's budget. So, and there will be market borrowing, private investment, okay, auctioning of completed highways. These are all options. And right now, Bharat Mala project, it will start in Gujarat and Rajasthan. It will be followed by Punjab. And then they'll be starting with the Himalayan belt, consisting of Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, then parts of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, then we have West Bengal, Sikkim, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, then coming down you will have Manipur and then Mizoram. This is how the Himalayan belt goes. It will be very near to the Purvanchal side, will be very near to the Indo-Burmese road as well. Okay, then it is directly going to Mizoram. There it ends. Okay, so the northeastern states, it will be having a very, it will be given a special focus in the project. Okay, one reason is because it is very near to the Indo-Myanmar border, then it is least developed area, there is no enough infrastructure. So, they will be giving more emphasis under this particular project. So, the main agencies with the constructions are National Highway Authority of India, and the Industrial Development Corporation, then PWD, state PWDs, okay, public work departments. Coming to the next topic, map aided program, I have Kalsubai here. So Kalsubai, it's a peak in Maharashtra and it is a part of Western Ghats. The speciality is it is known as the Mount Everest of Maharashtra. So, this is a main trekking, it is one of the main trekking place in Maharashtra. It's very famous and it is highest point in Maharashtra. The mountain range, it lies within the Kalsubai is Harishchandra Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary. So, Harishchandra range is there in Maharashtra. It is one of the peak of Harishchandra range and you can also see the wildlife sanctuary there. Okay. I have a map, okay, I have marked Kalsubai also. In previous year question revision series, I will read out the question. With reference to two non-conventional energy sources called coal bed methane and shale gas, consider the following statement. So, the coal bed methane is a pure methane gas extracted from the coal seams, while the shale gas is a mixture of propane and butane only that can be extracted from the fine grained sedimentary rocks. Okay, and the second statement is, in India, abundant coal bed methane sources exist, but so far no shale gas sources have been found. So this is the question. For a change, I want you guys to attempt the question and write the answer in the comment box, because every time I am giving you the answer, you are not, making an effort to answer the question. So, today you please attempt the question and give the answer in the comment box. Tomorrow, I will give you the answer of this particular question. Okay, let's see how far it works. Okay, so that's all for today, guys. Thank you so much. Have a good day.